Biggest challenge is a period piece. These guys are having to put on old equipment. It's old, it's heavy, it's hot. These guys are wearing all the old cotton stuff. We're shooting in Atlanta and, you know, in May and June and in July, the temperatures get up to 100 degrees, the humidity is 100%. It's grueling. And then when you try to add on the period stuff to it, all the equipment, all the old school stuff that we do, we're asking a lot out of them. So far, they've bought into it. They believe in what we're asking them to do, and hopefully it'll come off on screen well.
Okay, so we're going to say it's a martial practice. I mean, they're all dressed similar.
My name is Rourke Rucksager, and I take care of all the sports costumes. I'll get called from the football coach because I have a history with Mark Ellis, and I'll get a call from the costume designer. And we'll kind of get together, and then I'll talk to the coach and say, all right, how many players are we talking about? An amount of numbers, probably 325, 350 uniforms, including stunt doubles and background.
Living the dream.
We have our main team, which is Marshall, and then we have other teams we'll be playing against. So I'll go into yearbooks of universities in the area. I'll recreate exactly what it would be. I'll use the same materials. We have to take the gear that an athlete is used to nowadays because of the force of the blows, and take an old shoulder pad and build it new underneath. So if he takes his jersey off, the public goes, oh, that's an old shoulder pad, how's he doing that? But if you flip that shoulder pad over, it's a brand new shoulder pad underneath. Back in 70 and 71, we had suspension helmets. Your head was suspended in the shell. So if you get hit hard enough, your head could basically hit the shell. And then the masks. The masks are huge. The masks that we have on out there, some of them are recreated from that era. You'll see some masks out there that are from 71. Those will be very flat iron. And then you'll see some single and double bar plastic masks, which are holdovers from the late 50s and 60s. I'll put it together and you go out there and you can't tell the difference, but it's pretty much 1970, 71 gear.
I feel that I can go back to Huntington, West Virginia, and with my head held high, show the citizens of that community this picture and say, this is what we've done to bring your story to the world.
Marshall went in a barn burner, folks. They're going to remember this one for decades.
I really look forward to sharing it with the people most intimately connected to the crash, so hopefully it'll come together in that respect.
Touch on an event like this, and you're going to bring back memories and bring them right back to the forefront, put them on a screen. You're going to portray real people. And so they've so far really, really began to embrace this, and I think we did too. So it feels good.
McGee, the director, Matthew, are committed to making this movie a reflection of this community and a reflection of what really transpired here. And to that end, we'll honor those people that went before them. And I think that's our ultimate goal in making of this particular movie.
I think this movie is to football what Hoosiers was to basketball. You know, they can take all the football out of this movie and it's still a great story, because it is a story about not the people who died, but the people who survived.
You can start with a great blueprint, and you can bring in all these, you know, great casts and great director and amazing producers, and you can have all these amazing elements. And sometimes the whole is not greater than the sum of the parts. And I have a very strong feeling that this one it will be.
I'm listening to Coach.
Oh, baby, do the whistle blow!
All the way.